Hi, this is Mahesh from CRM Mats. In this video, I'm going to explain how we can create the custom PCF controls and how we can create the basic project PCF controls project and what are the prerequisites needs to be installed in our local machine. And these are the basic steps I'm going to explain in this video. Oh, let me go through those steps here. Here I have listed down these all the basic steps in this notepad. So the first step for creating a PCF control project is that we have to install the Node.js. So we have to go to the internet. So in the browser, and you can go to the Node.js.org. There you can go to the downloads here. And here you can see for Windows, and we can see the Windows installer. So currently my machine is 34-bit. I'm going to download this one and install the 34-bit Node.js. So once it is download it, when you open this MSI file, so it will prepare that Node.js installation wizard. So click on next, accept the terms and license agreements, click on next, and click on next, and click on next. And click on the next, and it will install it. So it will take some time to do the installation. So let's wait for that. So now this installation is successful. Click on the finish. Now let me go to the, what is the next step? We need to open the PowerShell. And we need to execute the command node v, so that will give the what is the version of the Node.js is got installed. So we can go to the Windows and open the PowerShell. So Windows PowerShell, here we can open this one. Well, let me copy this command. So now we can paste this command and execute. So this is the version of the Node.js we have installed. So we will get the version. So the next step, what we have to do, we have to download the Visual Studio Code. So we have to go to the internet again. So we have to go back to the internet, and you can see this code.visualstudio download, and we can download for Windows. So my Windows is 34-bit. So I can download that as a 34-bit. So it started downloading. So let it be once it is downloaded. So now it's downloaded. Let me install this one. So we can accept the agreement, click on the next. Next and install. It will take little bit time to install that Visio code. Okay, so now it's installed. So let me go to the next step. What is the next step is, so we have to install the Power Apps CLI. So let me go to the here internet and go to the Microsoft site. Let me go. So you can go to the Microsoft documentation and Power Apps CLI. So here we have it. We can go to the so we can download the CLI, Microsoft CLI here. So it's downloading now. So once it is downloaded, so we have to install it. This. So we have to accept the terms and click on installation. So this Power Apps CLI is got installation got finished. So the next step is that, so it will take some time to install that. After we install the Power Apps CLI, we need to validate that Power Apps CLI is the latest one we have downloaded. So we can go to the command prompt. So command bar, we can go to the Windows and open the command prompt. And we need to run as administrator that. We need to copy this command, pack, install latest one. So that will install, that will validate that Power Apps CLI will, it is installed the latest one or not. We can check it here. So this is saying that this a already is installed the latest package. Okay, so let me go to the next step there. So the next step is that we need to create a project for the PCF project. So in that, the first step, we need to create our own folder in our local machine. So let me go to here, go to the my D drive and so let me create my local folder here for PCF controls. I'm creating it as a new folder. I'm taking it as a PCF. This folder name. So let me go to the, once we created a local folder here, then I can go to the next step, open a command prompt and change my location. So let me copy the my folder location. So open here, copy this. Copy this folder location. And here, change the CD. That sorry. So once we change to the CD drive and PCF, and let me go to the next step. So the next step, we need to execute the PCF, the project creation statement. So like a command we need to execute. So this command is like initializing the new project. So in that statement, we have to give that namespace of the project, and we have to give the project name, and we have to tell that like a template, like in these templates, we have field or grid, database data set. So two types of the templates we can, two types of the projects we can able to create it. One is a field and other one is a data set. So I have created like a sample command here. So, and I have taken this command, and here I am taking this namespace as a CRM once and the project name as a CRM PCF project. So now let me go back to the here and paste this command and execute. So it will take a time to set up that project template and the folder structure. So here, see, I got an error. It's like a PC is that there is no recognized command. So let me check my command once again. Oh, sorry, there is a typing mistake. We have to give the double hyphen here. So I have corrected my command syntax. Let me copy it again. And go to the here and let me paste and run this time. So this time it started installing. This project is created successfully and it started running the NPM installation. So this NPM installation will take some time. Let me let run it. And once this NPM install, this command executed successfully, you can see like a 636 files. And the some of the files is got audited, like a 637 files are got audited. Now open the Visual Studio code, and open this folder which we created previously in my local machine. So let me open that folder. It goes on the D drive. And open it as this one as a PCF. And if you see here, we can have like a PCF project and Node.js modules got installed here. So if you go to the here and you can see it's generated. So let me go back to the PCF and select this folder. So that files will display here. So now here you can see this all the PCF files, what are the basic folder structure and the basic template files, package files also, it will come here. So we are going to discuss this, each folder structure and what is the purpose of the each file. We will discuss it in my next videos. So let me here. After we open this folder here, this folder structure is comes, everything is good. Now we can go to the last step for npm run build. So if we execute this one npm run build, so that our project will be our project. So our PCF control project will be built. So it started building that. So if we have like any compilation errors or anything, it will display here. So since it is a PCF plain, I mean, we haven't done any coding so far here. It's like a just one empty project we have created. So we are executing. So its build is succeeded. Now we can execute another command, npm start. So actually it will start that our PCF control project. It will open in a browser. So that control is So it will open this or control in locally. So these, so here you can see this is my PCF control, this namespace, and this is a web or in the tablet, what's the height and width, you can give it here, these properties, we can set it later. So this is how we can create a basic PCF control, folder structure and the installations we have to do. So let's see more about this folder structure and how we can do the coding here. So in my next videos, thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel.